How's it going, everybody? We got people dropping mad rupees. Freelancer wants that Chrono Trigger. Let's see, I think when last I checked, Final Fantasy IX was still in the lead. Yeah, with 20 requests. And Chrono Trigger just hit 20. Folks are really feeling that Chrono Trigger. Okay, let me make sure I've got it loaded up here. Yeah, I am just fine with that. I'm all about Chrono Trigger. Control Alt Cuteness asks, why not add a widget on the screen to show it? That's a good question. Because I don't know how to do that. But that's something I can figure out. And it's a good idea. And then as far as sprite goes, let me see what we got here. Looks like Freelancer gets that one too. Freelancer says Magus or Vegeta. I mean, if we're doing Chrono Trigger, we gotta do Magus, right? That's just not even a question. Okay. control. Cuteness says OBS allows capturing a section on a specific monitor. Ah, yeah, that would take some doing to set up. I'll look into it. I'm not sure. The way my monitor setup is, I'm not sure how feasible that is, TBH. Clone Trooper Kev asking, is Chrono on the list? Apparently, according to Talon of the Dragon. So that's up to Freelancer. It's Freelancer's choice right now. If Freelancer would like to swap out Chrono for Magus, they can do that. You can do that. But it's Freelancer's spot at this point. Speaking of spots, let me see how many we've got signed up. Right now we're at 45 racers in this particular race, which is an odd number, which means the deadline might get extended here. Can also select a window. Yeah, that might work better, although even then, like, the way the requests window works in Twitch, like, that involves scrolling because I've got so many options. Yeah, and if there is a way to, like, sort those. Freelancer says, sure, let's give Main Boy a spin. Okay, cool. Yeah, if he is on the list. Let's see. And yep, okay, we do in fact have an odd number of entrants. So we will have to wait for that to even out here. Mr. Safeway says, didn't see him. Yeah, let me, take a look here. Somebody had a, yeah, here we go. Here's the sprite list here. Yeah, I'm not seeing Chrono here. I am seeing Magus. Yeah, I think we might be doing Magus. Because I am not seeing Chrono on the sprite list. Here. Oh, okay. Sign-ups just closed, so we're good there. I'm gonna go ahead and... double check here, but... yep, okay, yes. Chrono Trigger does definitely win. So I'm going to complete that. That. Okay, there we go. Just got my seed. There's Magus. Background music's on. Yep, all that's set up right. Saving that. I have used both the tile and invisible link, and those are both pretty fine. The invisible link one's a little weird because it's... because it's hard to tell which way Link is facing until you get a shield. But other than that, trigger. Let's just make sure that this is working okay. Where is that sound coming from? Oh, there it is. Weird. I thought I'd... Never mind. We're fine. Okay. Let's see here. Now, okay. Green mail, green pendant, bottle boots. Cool. We're good there. I-N-K. Boom. All right. Make sure to get back. All right. We good. Ugh. Look at the dregs on the bottom of that coffee. It's the last bit of my cold brew there. All right. I've got enough time left. I'm gonna chug this down and go get some warm coffee because I'm feeling a little chilly. We'll be right back. Okay, and we back. All right. Got my controller. Got all the timers going. Ugh. Pardon me. All right. Oh, I need to change my mode here because we are playing casual boots, not open mode. There we go. Now we're good. I'm gonna need to make a racing overlay for League. I don't think I'm allowed to have that mode and timer way up there in the game screen for restreaming purposes. Also, there we go. Hey, what's up, coffee burps? Ironically, I was just experiencing coffee burps. Just a second ago there. Water. Got my local recording happening. I'm fairly sure I set up Nightbot to remind people not to backseat, although that's on a slow timer, so. Oh yeah, okay, yep. I'm scrolling up on the chat. That is still happening, so we're good there. I got my tracker with boots and sword. I had to put my fuzzy slippers on because my feet was cold. It's getting to be that time of year where the ice bath. Mm. where the ice bath keeps me chilly for longer. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and switch the audio over, take this timer off screen. That timer is a little off anyway because the sign-ups got extended when we had an odd number.
Oh my god!
Hey Ben, take my money.
Hey, thanks Dark Rydan. T-Fry asked, do you empty the ice bath in the winter months? No, heck no! I keep doing it in the winter months. It's just, you know, less pleasant. I mean, it's never pleasant to be in the ice bath. But it takes longer to recover from, and the recovery is less pleasant. Not MSG Free asks, do you get winter in Arizona? We do. It's, you know, it's still warm during the afternoon, but it cools down at night. Okay, I just got the 1 minute warning from the bot. Arbiter Argent, thank you for the Prime sub. T-Fry asked, how does it not freeze? That's adorable. I mean, I don't have to run it as much. I don't have to run it as much to keep ice in there. I've got it on a timer that cycles it on and off, and during the winter months, it's only actually running like a couple hours a day instead of like 20 hours a day. But, oh, 30-second warning. Gotta pay attention now. 10 seconds. Three, two, one. Spooky time. That's right. Thank you, Lone Warrior. Hey, second sword right off the bat. Navy Blue Wolf wants to know, what benefits do the ice bats give you? That is hard to say, actually. Oh, snap! Talon making it rain on all kinds of folks. Thank you, Talon. Yeah, it seldom gets below freezing in Arizona, and not for, like, sustained periods. Hook shot! Ooh, and stun prizes bombs. Love it. Gotta remember to use my boots. Oops. Hey, there's more bombs. But yeah, somebody was asking me what benefits do ice baths give you? They're supposed to have all kinds of health benefits. I am not a medical professional. I would make no claims to that effect. No specific claims. I believe that it has some health benefits because I have seen friends who have legit health problems have those health problems reversed in a way that they at least attribute to the ice bath. It's supposed to help with weight loss. Yep, it's supposed to boost testosterone. T-Fry asks, possibly a placebo effect? I'd be very surprised if that was all it was. Because people don't tend to use ice baths as a first resort. Yeah, I mean, a placebo could certainly be part of it. Absolutely. Absolutely. Lady Devois says, boost testosterone. I need to avoid them at all costs, then. I don't know if there's a reason for you saying that. A specific reason that is specific to you. But testosterone is not only a guy thing. It is, in fact, great for everyone, even if, as your screen name implies, you are a lady person. Here's your fun medical fact for the day. Women can absorb testosterone from semen when having unprotected sex. Which is one of the reasons why sex tends to be a mood lifter. Not the only reason, certainly, but a big one. Okay, Lady Devois says I'm trans. Okay, and yeah. Gonna be going through hormone therapy trying to reduce testosterone. Okay, that makes sense. That's why I said I don't know if there is a reason specific to you. Turns out that there is. That's why I made sure to include that proviso, because I don't want to presume things when people say stuff like that. Also, yeah, swords galores. And a blue cane, I'll take it. Ooh, magic. Oh, and just in case I didn't already have all the bams. Even more bams. What we got up here. I think that was arrows. Dark Raiden asking, why did that area light up if I didn't have a light source? Because otherwise the randomizer would be forced to put lamp very early in the seed, so that's a convenience feature. Or it would require everybody to go through that area in the dark, which would not be great for beginners. Suppose I could mark bombs on my tracker if I wanted. Moon Pearl! Pulling me crazy off course so far. Ooh, and hammer! Alright, just need a glove for that DW. Mirror, you say? Magic. Oh man. Loaded. Absolutely loaded. Ice rod. Either it'll come in handy or it won't. Let's talk to Batter, shall we? It's Red Meringue! That. Yeah, South Shore. Yep, still need glove. $50. How's it going, Cost the Monster? Woo. And there's them gloves. There's them gloves that I loves. All right, so that's my DW there. Thank you. 5 red rupees. All right, sure, we'll do that. Hello, Magus, my old friend. Some water walking to Hobo here, and then okay, just $20 there. What you got for me, friendo? Grab Hype Cave and then see where we at. It's fine. You can have that rupee. It's fine. I didn't want it anyway. You're a jerk. Bottle, you say? Ooh. And the other boots. Okay. And shroom. I should map check at this point. Okay, Green Pendant Desert. Don't need that. Bonk. Okay. Pendant, Pod, and Ice. Red Mire and Thieves. Go talk to Bottle Boy, and then let's clear Thieves Town, why not? $300! Nice.
Oh my god!
Hey, thanks, Hunter Prime. pretty sure that bottle is empty. My hearts are a little rough. It occurs to me I probably should have gone the other way first, routing wise. Oh well. I'm here, so this is what I'm doing. I could probably use the refill anyway. Fuck it. Oh, jeez. Oh, God, I'm sucking. I was doing a dumb. There we go. Alright. Death warp me again. Let's do the death warp again. Bombs. Okay, that was the other item in here, so now I just need a key to let me out of this dumb place. And I'll be good. And there it is. Well, at least I've got full hearts again, but yeah, that whole field trip was dumb. I should have done Thieves Town first and then gone north and done that on the way to Graveyard Ledge and that stuff. Oh well. It's a big key! It's a big key. That was the big key.
Oh my God!
I had to renew. Who knew? Twitch knew. That's who.
Hey, flippadips! Oh, I missed the bunny beam. Pretty sure he turns into Alphador. Also, thank you, Jay Nerdlin. Okay, so that's three of the four items in here, I do believe. Them flips is a good find, though. So that means when I go north from here, I can go all the way into Zora area. Route that with catfish. I do have powder if I need it for safety's sake. Gotten all the items in here. Don't need to worry about picking up items. You just gotta kill that boss. You know what? Swamp is full clearable, on the other hand. Rip script. All right. First crystal, 26 minutes in. And there's that last sword. Sure, why not? Oop. Morph that. Bloop. Bams. Ba-ba-doo-doo. Ledge. Good to know. Maybe. I don't know. I don't know if that's good to know. Is that good to know? What do we know? Do we know things? Let's find out. Thank you. Okay. This.
Whee!
Another bottle. How am I doing on Roops? Not good enough. In fact, I need to farm some before I get to Zora. See if that would drop. Oh well. Oops. Ah, well, I get another chance. Give this witch a mushroom. Hey, there's some Roops. In fact, that's so many Roops. I can get one of these. Oh, heck yes, Talon. That's exactly what I do. Marl is Nadia. Frog is Glenn. Magus is Yanis. Robo is R66Y. The Epoch is Arrow, short for Arrow Dalton Imperial. You know that's what I'm about. I saw that, Blaster Master Guy Gratz. Hey, fairy. Nice. Okay, just $50 there. Hey, how's it going, Floyd? That's been a pretty kind seed so far. Partial refund. Other people call it a scam, they call it a life lesson, I call it a partial refund. It's fine. Sure if this is the right way to do this. TBH. It's probably totally not. Oh well, fuck it. When will I attempt another serious NMG run? Probably not in a while. Probably not for a while. I've got, what, 7 weeks minimum of League coming up? Where am I in the league? I'm in the open league, in the what you call it, desert division. Lamp, you say? Well, here I was, just thinking, you know, if I had Lamp, I'd probably go into Pod. But because I don't, so little of it is in Logic. But now that I got that Lamp, I feel like now's the time. I feel like, fuck it, let's do this thing. This might be silly, because that also puts Hera in Logic and Swamp's bin full clearable. But, eh. Fuck it. Titans! Okay, what all do I need now? What all do I need now? I need bow. I need fraud. I need red cane. Hey, it's a shield. Okay. So at this point, yeah, I'm gonna piece out of this because none of this is in Logic right now. I'm gonna go up the mountain. That's what I'm gonna do. Although, is that the way? Well, fuck it. It's the way I'm doing it, because I'm walking that way now. Probably should have done swamp first. Oh well. I need flute, and I need bow, fraud, flute, and red cane minimum. Quakums might need it, so I should grab it now. Yep. big key. There's one of the two items to be found in here. Boom, first try sleazy every time. I'm the best. There's the other item. No worries about basement. Murder that boy. That's a crystal. I got a crystal from Moldy Boy. Alright. Jeez, there it is. Okay. Oh, there's that bombums. So that means ice is now full clearable. Not what I want to see, since ice is a pendant. Ridmail! Okay, that's everything I can get here in the light world. There's my roops. There's a bunch of my roops. Let's see what we need in order to get into Trock here. Bombos, okay, interesting. I suppose it didn't matter now, did it? Because I've got all of them. doody doot. Loving it. Which makes desert clearable. For a green pendant. You know what? That desert might not be a bad idea. Let's go there first. Or no, not desert. Well, desert area might not be terrible. Regardless, let's turn in this flute. I'm half tempted to do Smith Chain while I'm here. That'll kick me out right near desert anyway. Boots, flute, and mirror, Smith Chain will go quick. So yeah, I'll do this, I'll do swamp. Alright, don't need that. Sorry about that noise that keeps popping. That's my WhatsApp. And there is not much I can do about it. Time for this swamp play. This has been in the cards for a minute now. Probably should have done this quite a bit earlier, actually. Yep. Feels good when I get that good dash there. It's a good thing. I wanted to do the hammer dash. Because it feels good. Yeah, there's enough stuff that I still need that I can't justify skipping left side. And you know what? Especially since bombs are stun prize, I don't even need to worry about running out of bombs if I goof up Diver Down too bad. Although, I've got my full 10 bombs. It would take some doing to goof it that bad. This boy got him away. Okay. Boom! First try. And I was worried. And yeah, that WhatsApp is my, is Amanda AJK Kitchen, who I have asked to read and respond to that Medium article that I read on stream the other day. So that is probably her giving me comments on that. A whole lot of good stuff here so far. Yeah, Dark Raiden, you can do, it's easier with Red Cane and it's faster. But all you need is bombs. Floyd's asking, what's the appeal of WhatsApp over just SMS? The big advantage is that it works even for folks, it works internationally. It is region agnostic, so it's very nice for people who travel out of the country a lot. Hey, it's the bow! I think I got my item count wrong here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure there needs to be. Yeah. There's two items left. Oops, crud. Yeah, I forgot that. Oi, fraud! Okay, so what? So I just need red cane now. Do I go back in for that one last item? I do. After this, Bugnet. Eastern and Pod, probably. Yeah. Except, I'm gonna check this area. These are fast checks, and there! That's why I wanted to check this area! Oh, baby! Because if I hadn't checked that... Okay, so that's my go mode, pretty sure. Point. I might as well just... Oh, is this gonna bonk me? Nope, I'm good. Because, yeah, now I can do Mire. Because, yeah, I can do... Eastern's full clearable. Skull's full clearable. Mire and Trock are both full clearable, so yeah, that was my go mode rod. My go rod. Gonna aim for the true god Mire here. The godliest of Mires. Nope, 'twas not to be. Among Us mod that replaced the crewmates with xenomorphs? Oh! Faux Godmire, Fodmire. Should have just done that to begin with. Hoo-ha! That's a pretty godly Mire. Don't get it twisted. Thank you. I suck. Okay, we're good. We're good. We're good. So weird how sometimes it takes a... I guess I'm not high enough. Alpha door! Okay, seriously, get back here, fucker. Whatever, I've got a fairy. Okay. So I need to do Eastern. I need to do I've still got a blue goo in one of my bottles. Did I pick up a third bottle somewhere? I'm not sure. Arrows quicker than butter? Actually, that's a good question. Probably? I believe it's two swipes with butter. But the thing is, well, you know what? Butter might be faster if you have the hearts to wade into the slime to go after him, instead of waiting for him to come to you. Actually, wait, no, I think it's more than two swipes with butter. I don't know. Probably shave some time by advancing on Vidi while I'm firing. Floyd is probably right about that.
Oh my god!
That's a long time.
That is a long time. 25 months! At tier 2, no less. Thank you, Achilles Warlord. This, I gotta kill Moth, and then it's up to Trock. That damage boost just right on the first try. Not that I'm worried with red mail and 13 hearts, but it's the principle of the thing. Oh, I should have. I should have capped that fairy. Oh, well. I've got powder and bug net. I don't really have to worry about capping fairies when they spawn randomly. Rup, fat fingered that. Rup, that dash. Oh, well. Oops. Speaking of fat fingers. Wake up, fucker. Ah. I morphed it. I goofed it. To skull. Whee! Suppose I can burp, pop off go mode on my tracky poo there. That fairy was a jerk. Almost missed the key there. I thought I had it, but I didn't. And if I hadn't gotten it, I would have been wondering, what? What happened? I would have said it just like that, too. What happened? I wanted to go to the door, but I couldn't, because I just don't know why. Don't get 1.0'd! That's a dead moth. That's a dead moth. That moth is dead. That is a dead moth. All right, up to Trock. Do Ow. Whew. Okay. We good. Attention to my keys here. See if I can steal the key. See if I can skip big chest. These are the things that I need to be paying attention to right now in my brain, and I'm saying them out loud so I don't forget to think about them with my brain. What am I doing? A bad habit of just menuing when I do not need to. Hopefully quick swap helps break me of that. Well, that's a key. Bloop. Those are not keys. And that's not an item dash. And that makes me sad. You change humps. Ooh, Talon making it rain again. Thank you, Talon of the Dargon. All right, no big key yet, so I cannot steal this small key coming up. Should grab those arrows, though. It's good to have arrows. Vanilla big key. Glad I didn't leave that behind. Means I will probably have to do Lazy Bridge, though. And this has been such an insane jet seed. It's getting to the point where I'm eyeing that Discord for the ping. Just bombs! Which means I will have to go to Lazy Bridge, most def. Thank you. Hey! A gift. Kyodaibot gets a mighty gift. Thank you, Talon of the Dragon. Thank you so much for all of the generosity today. Yep, well, that was easy. Sword fight. Oh, I missed that last slash apparently. Crap. Do we have a mod who can open that shiz up? The bets that is? Cause it's that time. Thanks, Skirtspur. I gotta get better about my spin speed. That almost certainly cost me more time than it saved. Also, sure, what's up with my tracker? GT's showing up orange, but it should be full clearable? Number one. Number two. Number four and silvers. Number five. Number six. Oop. Oh, okay. It just turned green. Apparently, it considers Ganon not in logic without silvers, and that's what that's about. Number seven, Bob Lives. Eight. Nine, and a shield. 10. 11. Oh, you're a jerk. Nope. Yeah. There we go. Is this 12? I lost count. Pretty sure that's 12. Oop, come on. Fourteen, 15, 16, 17. It's time for Bob's barely legal chest, y'all. Thank you, Achilles Warlord, for giving that mighty gift to Lutheran. Gotta get that shit out of my system. I made a barely legal chess number 18 joke when I was commentating once, and I got in trouble for it. 18. Twenty-one! And a freebie. I am eyeing that Discord window so hard. Oh, fucker. Using Fire Rod from the beginning there. Spending the magic and saving the menu. Oh well. Did not need that chest. There is pretty much nothing in that chest that could help me. Also, I have a fairy in a bottle, don't I? Yes, I do. Neat. It's not aware of that. Oh, I see a ping. I don't know if it's the ping, but I see a ping. Yep, that's the ping. Womp womp. Well, I'm gonna check this anyway. We're unvalidated. Yeah, this was a total jet seed. It would not take much for me to get beaten here. Nice close race, though.
Like I'm just in time for the end of the stream.
Hey, how's it going, B-Scar? Oh, so close to a triple there. Hey, thanks, Lone Warrior. Well, that was weak sauce. Let's go fight a pig, shall we? Come on. Trolloports. That's three. And that's four. Getting in my dot done.
I'm never hesitant to say fuck the president.
Boom. Boom. Pretty sure that's a Peebers. I'm 2 minutes late. Let's see if that's true. Yeah, more like 3 minutes 45 late. Still, look at that. Look at that! Ba-ba-ba-boom! Fun seed, though. Fun seed, absolutely. So yeah, that's two Peebers in a row. Crazy. Let me just get my GGs to my opponent who beat me. GamerCal. What is the time difference needed for it to be called a tie? I think like 10 seconds or something. Something like that. All right, let's roll them creds. Thank you very much to Scrivener for the bits. Thank you to the mods and the bots and the bots that are also mods. Welcome to Cam H, King of the Cyber Jews, Cherry Cheese Brittany, and Sean Skevington. And thank you to Narelm, D-Mystic, Control All Cuteness, Dark Raiden, Arbiter Argent, Joe Devon, Firescadal, Owlmite, Koval White, Darian Strezzo, Captain Ty, Nerdling, You Forgot, Letter D, Bard Euphoria, Sean Skevington, Hunter Prime, Jay Nerdling, Don K, Achilles Warlord, Ace Peacecraft, Vorpal, Wondrous Magnet, Devon, Zoobs, Kyodaibot, Lutheran the Fox, Beskar, Coffee Burps, Nix Aches, Awesome Dude, Hyper the Holy Hamster, and the Vegetor for the subs and resubs. Special thanks to Lone Warrior and Talon of the Dragon for the sub bombs. Thank you so much, guys, for all the generosity today. Well, GamerCal had more words. Said his two big mistakes were going pod after Eastern and not knowing about Samaria. So he went pod after Eastern, but before Skull Woods and Death Mountain. Man, his routing must have been really different. I'm going to have to check that out. So yeah, geez, if he did all of pod and still beat me. Well, all of it except for... Yeah, I don't know. I'm going to need to watch his VOD and see how he did. Good stuff. Good stuff indeed. Very close race, Talon of the Dragon. Yeah, like 3 minutes 45 seconds. Crazy close. And the mini explosions sleep again. Forever! Man, it's crazy. There are 12 other racers, no, 14 total, that have already finished their race at barely an hour and a half. That is crazy. And that's just on a regular-ass ladder race in the middle of the day. Phew. I mean, yeah, casual boots, so it's one of the fastest. Anyway. Let's see. I should wait for these credits to end so that I get it all in my VOD for record-keeping purposes. Coffee Burp says, I've got a stupid question. What are casual boots? So casual boots is the mode. It is a... Yep. Skirtspur has the... There are commands for all of the common modes that we use here. But it's standard start... meaning that you start in Link's house, And go through the escape sequence with the rain and all that normal stuff. 7-7, which means 7 crystals to get into GT and 7 crystals to beat Ganon. And you start with both a sword and the boots equipped. Yeah. So you don't have to worry about trying to kill enemies without a sword. You have the boots the whole time, so you can dash everywhere. It's just a nice, like... They call it casual, because it's a nice, like, hey, here's some bare minimum stuff that you can... So you don't have to... It's less likely that you're going to have to do some stupid stuff like, I don't know, hammer blind fight. Hammer blind fight would be bad. I do not think we have rolled a swordless run for mystery. We've rolled some pretty bad seeds, though. I think that's about the only worst thing that I might have had to deal with that I didn't. It is only 2:37. I should drive to the post office and drop off my ballot. I tried to do that yesterday, only then I remembered that, oh yeah, some dude came to the North American continent a couple hundred years back and really wrecked up the place, and for some goddamn reason that's a bank holiday now. Look at that. One tempered sword boss fight, 8 gold sword. So much gold sword today. GT Big Key. Technically spot 20. Really spot 21. So we didn't actually collect that shovel on torch. Oof. 20-minute drive to the bank? That sucks, Scoot the Boot. Alright, and there we go. And there we go. Alright. Well, at this point, I'm going to check what all those messages were from my editor. Probably, yeah. See if I can take another pass through that Medium article. I want to make a pizza tonight, but I can't even start preheating the oven until 6. Because the way electricity works here. But also... That was barely an hour and a half of playtime. Not even an hour and a half of playtime. I'm going to play some Fall Guys. Just for a little bit. Before calling it into this stream. That second season is happening now. There's like castles and stuff. I want to see what's up with that. Mr. Timmy GS, when are you planning? Oh, you know what? Yeah, let's do that. I will try the return of Obra Doodle. We'll try it. Probably just for like a half an hour here, but I'm in a good mood right now, despite that loss. If Fall Guys will finish booting up so that I can boot it down, that is. Come on. I know how to play. Shut up. Ooh, remix. There we go. All right. Return of the Oberdoodle is downloading. It's less than a gig, so it shouldn't take long. Just gonna take a look at, you know what? No, I'm not gonna take a look at my WhatsApp messages until I've done this, because then I won't want to do it no more. Yeah, according to Mr. Timmy G, this game is best played blind, so no spoilers. No spoilers, por favor. Alright. Let me just switch the game over here. Switch that to Oberdin. That seems like it's coming in real loud. See if I can adjustify that sum for y'all. Here we go. Just drop that down to about half volume, and there we go. Still seems a little loud. There we go. That seems a little better. Okay. Lost at Sea, 1803, the good ship Oberdin, built 1796, London, 800 tons, 18-foot draft. Captain R. Witterell, crew 51 men, last voyage to Orient, Cape Rendezvous unmet. Contact East India... Is that company? East India Company, London office, for inquiries or testimony. The Honourable East India Company. Attention, Chief Inspector, Insurance and Claims, London office. The Oberdin has returned. Dispatch to Falmouth immediately and prepare a full assessment. Falmouth, England, 1807.
Company man woke me up. Said you'd need ferry to the Oberdin. Not many eager for that job. Seems a bit late if you ask.
I didn't.
What's in the box?
I don't know.
What's in the box?
Hoist it up in a few minutes.
Hey! Ow!
Carefully.
So yeah, this is I've seen a little bit of this. Like, when I say a little bit, I mean like 30 seconds, and to be honest, the graphical style turned me off some. Like, props for having a graphical style and committing to it, but oops, nope. Boop, there we go. Ooh, okay. All right. I can move. Oh, now I have hand. Oh, there we go. Can I have my box, though? Oh. OK. Okay, all right. So the hand shows up when there's something I can interact with, it seems like. What's that thing? Is it getting closer? Certainly seems that way. That's probably not good. Or is it just an optical illusion?
Oi! It's too heavy!
All right.
Take it yourself or open it here.
All right. Gimme. Okay, I can has book. D? Oh, okay. WASD. Okay, all right. Return of the Obra Dinn, a catalogue of adventure and tragedy, 1807. Preface. I trust that you now find yourself aboard the Obra Dinn. I expected this day to come, and my every intention was to tell the ship's strange tale within the pages of this book. Regrettably, failing health has allowed me to produce only the basic outline that follows. You know what I just realized? I'm still recording local because of the race. I can stop that. Your presence on the Obra Dinn is critical. I leave the discovery of its fate and the completion of this book in your hands. The next few pages will seem bewildering at first. All will make sense in time. I doubt that. Use the pocket watch to determine the identity and fate of everyone aboard. Complete each chapter accurately and return the book by guaranteed post to the French Office of Affairs in Morocco. The bargain chapter will remain unknown to you. I possess the details within, but have elected to keep them private for now. Henry Evans. All right. Chapter one, the journey, the ship, the crew. All right. Okay, sure. The journey, Atlantic leg of the Far East route. Okay. So we set sail from England, went this way, past the Canary Islands, this way, past Cape Verde, and down this way, into the Cape. Okay. All right. The ship, deck plans for the Obra Dinn, captain's quarters, passenger cabins, it's the main deck, we got a gun deck. With quarters for first, second, third, and fourth mates, bosun mate, stewards, midshipmen, orlop deck, purser's office, passengers, port walk, gunner's store, surgery crew, starboard walk, carpenter's shop, cargo hold, captain's cargo, passenger cargo, Lazarette, bosun store. All right. The crew, complete crew and passenger manifest. All right. Mostly English folks, some Scots, some Irishes, an Austrian, a Frenchman. A Pole? Is that right? An Italian, Indian, Swede, Wales, okay. Okay. Seamen, some Indian seamen. Alright, sure. Sketches of life aboard the Obra Dinn. Oh, interesting. Underway. All right, these guys all seem happy. They're dancing. Who this lady, though? Is that a lady? Looks like a lady. Man what plays the fiddle. Formosan royalty. Justice at sea. Ooh. Whoa. So they hung him up and then shot him? Huh. Yeah, I know Polish is the adjective, but what would be the noun? Like, is Polish the noun too? Like, I could say I am American, or I could say I am an American. But could you say he is a Polish? I don't think you would say that. I know grammatically you can say he is a Pole, but I don't know if that's one of... I don't know if that's, yeah, the proper term. Loose cargo. If he's a real, you know, if he likes to swing, you know, if he's a real hep cat, would that make him a pole cat? Part one, loose cargo. Part two, on the cargo deck. Okay. Okay. This is just all blank. Unholy captives. All right. The Doom. All right. This chapter will remain unknown until you leave the ship and return the book to me. All right. Glossary. Okay, all right. Head officer in command of the ship, responsible for this. Okay. Mate, officer, tradesman. Okay. General mates help to run the ship. All right. Foreman in charge of general crew operations and the equipment required to stay on the ship. Okay. Charge of weapons and military procedures. All right. Ship's doctor in charge of crew health. Yep, all right. Most of these things are what they sound like and sound like what they are. Steward. Officer in training. Okay. Alright, general manual, okay, rigging, yep. Main deck, gun deck, yep. Orlop deck, mid deck, above the lowest. Okay. Animal pens, alright. Huh. Alright. We got a compass, apparently. Memento mortem. Remember death. There's a conjugation thing happening there. Apparently, memento mortem is remember death. I'm used to memento mortis, which I believe is remember that you are mortal. At least that's the way I've heard it translated. All right. I'm still that sparkly thing off in the distance is not sure about that. Oh, hello. Was this here before? Oh. All right.
Captain, open the door. Kick it in. Ah, lest we break it down and take more than those shells.
You bastards may take exactly what I give you.
Okay. Huh. So this is like a flashback to what happened. I'm guessing. Oh, I'm noticing something, because this door was locked earlier, and it's got a little X there. This one opened, and it's got a little line like a keyhole. I wonder if that's consistent, because that would be nice. We've got a guy right here. All right, so it's looking like a mutiny? Okay, so outside the captain's quarters, who is this? How did they die? Location of the corpse and three others were present. All right. This unknown soul. This person's face appears blurred throughout the book. You don't have... Okay, I can't determine their identity. Their fate may be known and can be entered now. Huh. Faces will become unblurred when the information necessary to identify them has been revealed in some way. Okay. All right. Shot. Gun. This unknown soul was shot with a gun by an unknown attacker. I mean, they called him Captain. That's probably him, right? Can I not get back here? Guess not. Okay, so I'm digging that this seems, because I was... Oh, I'm trying to remember. When was it? So yeah, I toured an old sailing ship. It was when I was in London, that's right. And yeah, like... You look at shit like this, like, yeah, this is, like, these quarters here, these cramped-ass little quarters, these are probably, like, the first mate's quarters. These are, like, the nice quarters, which is nice. Like, this actually feels like it is to scale in a way that you don't often see in fiction. In fiction, boats often seem, like, redonkulously... Like, way bigger than they have any right to be. Okay, so that's the captain. That's, we don't know who, but we know he was shot with a gun by the captain. And this guy was present. Huh. Also, this guy. And this is where, huh. And this is where they were at the time. So would that have been, that would have been on the return voyage, it looks like. There's this fainter line here. Or no, is that, no, that's just a ray coming off of the little compass here. Huh. Okay, so that filled in on that map. Okay, so that and that cross references to what just happened. All right. So if I go down to Justice at Sea, interesting. Okay, so that the captain. Yeah, okay. Interesting. All right. Huh. All right, so what else am I supposed to be doing in here? Oh, okay. Now this door is open. So I think that's saying I've figured out what I'm supposed to figure out in that little scene, and now I can leave it. All right. All right. And we got another corpse over here.
Where are they? Must be in here someplace.
They're at the bottom of the sea.
That's a lie.
Was this guy the captain? I think so, because the captain had the mustache and the soul patch. Not sure what caused me to go into the book before. So, okay, so this would be after. Oh. All right. Because the guy's already dead. This unknown soul. Knifed? Yeah. Was knifed by Captain Witterel. Okay. Okay, and he's that guy. And this looks like he's bald-headed with an open shirt here. And the captain had his shirt off, I think. Alright, is there anything else to learn here? Oh, hello! Okay. Alright, so yeah, before he was heading up above, so yeah, he was trying to He was trying to get around and get the drop on the captain. Okay. Alright, so that door's open. Yeah, because he was right here before. This bald dude with the knife in his mouth. So he went over the side there. Huh. Alright. And now there's another corpse over here. I'm guessing the captain's corpse, unless he did a real damn good job, because he was getting, like, speared in the chest before, and that other dude was about to come up behind him. Okay, all right. The captain is a flippin' badass. Because he knifed that guy and then turned around and smacked this dude on the head, except this is a different dude because he's got a beard. Or is he a different dude? Oh, no, he's bald-headed. I guess I just missed the beard before. Huh. Oop, but he did get knifed. He got knifed in the side. So which one is the corpse? Oop, and there's somebody. Can't tell if that's a lady. Okay. All right, so yeah, it is this dude's corpse. Don't know who it is, but they got... Spirit struck. Oh, nope. Not any of those things. Alive, axe, burn, clubbed. There we go. Was clubbed by Captain Witterel. Memories where this person appears can be navigated from here. Oh, interesting. I'm in love with marriage. She's my main thing. She makes me feel alright. She makes my heart sing.
Loot bits for secret knowledge.
Thank you, Roaring Liger. Just the buttons at the top of the page to edit bookmarks and navigate between them. Alright. Neat. All right. So yeah, I'm wondering because she does not look well. Was there like a plague or something? Is she sick? That's the first place my mind goes. Okay, so there's something over there, but let's check this person first. And yeah, it's a skeleton. It's hard to tell.
Your brother, my friend. I shot him dead. I'll be with you soon. Forgive me.
Roaring Liger, that song is called Mary Jane by Rick James. Huh. Open the book while examining a face to flip directly to the sketch. All right. Oh, that dude's... Okay, this unknown soul was... Huh. So yeah, that was the guy who was shot before. And now it's saying I should be able to identify them. I'm guessing this is Abigail? Okay, this person's face is no longer blurred, which means they can now be identified. Use the book and the pocket watch to gather enough information to deduce their identity. Revisit memories on the ship using the pocket watch to study relationships, appearances, and activities. So I'm guessing she's Abigail, and if I can figure out who her brother was... It's the book, maps, crew manifest, and artist sketches along with the individual. Okay. There were 60 people on the ship when it left England. All right. Decisive information is rare. You'll have to make assumptions using partial information. Some identities may... I mean, I'm assuming that he was talking to her when he said Abigail, but who knows? All right, let's see if we can find an Abigail on this crew manifest. Right. Okay. Abigail. Oop, here we go. Abigail Hoskett Witterell. Okay, so same last name. Could the captain be her brother? Or wait, no. Because it's Hoskett Witterell. So she's the captain's wife, and Hoskett's her brother. Okay, so yeah, I've been assuming that this is the captain, and it's saying this is the same person. So, okay. Captain. Suicide by gun. This may or may not be correct. Okay. Fates are validated in sets of three. All right. Correctly identify at least three people and their fates to have the information typeset into the book. Okay, all right. So this is just a theory so far. Okay. So one of these guys would be Hoskett, because he just said, I've killed your brother. So yeah, let's get out of this memory, because there was another memory. Because yeah, actually, yeah, it could be any of those three, because he just killed three people. Oh, this is the Papers, Please guy? I played a little bit of that one. Martin. Okay, all right. Captain is her husband. Okay. Okay, so she got smacked in the face with a mask during a Kraken. There's a Kraken attacking. So this guy's got a beard, but he's also got a full head of hair, so I don't think he's the same guy from before. Alright. Okay, yeah, I got that. How do I go back to... Huh, so it's not letting me fill in her fate, though? Oop. Huh, and it's... Oh, wait. There we go. Still getting used to the controls here. I mean, it doesn't have to be a fantastical element. It could be a mundane Kraken. You don't know. The Doom. Okay, the corpse was moved post-mortem. All right. Ten others were present? Okay, I gotta look around a little more then. Crushed by rigging, I guess. Yeah, crushed by rigging. Yeah, that seems. Yep. Okay, my compass is doing jiggly bits. Okay, yeah, a bunch of other people here. Okay, what's special about this guy? Okay, compass is doing stuff. It's pointing this way. Okay, all right. Okay. All right, it wants me to go in here now? Okay, we got a guy with tattoos. It's hard to tell because the graphical style. That's... Okay. All right, so this is... All right. Okay. All right. Huh. All right, so it says I should be able to figure out who he is now, but I don't. Huh. Yeah, let's, Oh, wait, nope, there we go. And that's this guy. Can't know who he is yet. Pretty sure that's tattoos. Oh, okay. Okay. So he died. Crushed by a beast? Yeah, all right. Yeah, that sounds right. Okay, and now my compass is jiggling and wriggling again. Okay, it wants me to look at this person. Okay, so I think when it does that, it's showing where the corpse moved after death. So, well, let's watch this play out first. What in the... Is that an explosion that's happening? Does this for ones that don't have bodies left on the boat? Huh. Oh, geez, there's a silhouette in there. And they're tied to a rope? Huh. All right, so two questions, if you can tell me without spoiling anything. About how long is this game? And how often does it save? Because I would like to come back to this when I have some time to dedicate to it. This has been really cool, but I don't think I'm going to have time to get too far into it today. I don't like how it just kicks you out like that. Okay. Don't need to save. Saves instantly all the time. Okay, cool. Who is this? How did they die? Well, don't know who it is, but exploded seems like a pretty safe bet. Alright. Oh, yep, says auto-saved. Alright, quit to title. Alright. This is cool. That's really neat. I will definitely be coming back to this. I'm glad... I am glad, Mr. Timmy G. I am glad that you kept on me about trying this out. Because that seems really cool. And I am glad that I tried it out today. Because today is a day that I was in the mood to engage with something new. I think that's the sort of thing that could easily have frustrated me if I was in a tetchy mood, as I tend to get in sometimes. So I'm glad I saved that for a day when I was in a receptive mood to what it is dropping, to pick up what it's putting down. So yeah. Let's, well, first of all, let me see if, all right. So, yeah. Yeah, I might do some of this on Sunday. I put out a ping to Yodanashi and Worldwide Wimpy about maybe getting another day of co-op training in on Sunday. If not, I might come back to this on Sunday. But yeah, I'm gonna want to give this a dedicated stream where I can sit down and get up in it. I could maybe do it on Friday, although I wouldn't mind getting another open race in. One last race of the season. Might play a little bit on Saturday. Depends on what kind of a mood I'm in. I don't know. We'll see. But I definitely want to return to this. All right. Thanks for tuning in, you guys. Final order of business. Let's find somebody to raid. Let's see. Looks like Willer J. Bradley is playing Final Fantasy VI. He's doing some Worlds Collide randomizer. Let's see how he's doing. Slash raid. Blow. All right. See you guys next time. Thank you, Mr. Timmy G, for gifting me that game. All right. Bye-bye.